get the latest on the condition of Filipinos in Israel. We're now joined by the officer in charge of the Department of Migrant Workers, Undersecretary Hans Leo Kaktak. Undersecretary, thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Yes, good noon, Ms. Carmi, and all your tele viewers.
Do we already have a handle on the missing Filipinos? I understand that there are 10 that are unaccounted for. What's the latest on that?
Well, right now that number is down to 5. We've accounted for about 4 more in the last 18 hours or so. And of course, the effort continues to account for the 5. They are, of course, have been coordinated. Their names have been coordinated with the Israeli Defense Forces who are on the ground conducting operations, as well as the Filipino community in the southern part.
Undersecretary, tell us about the process and how difficult it is to really get a handle on the situation of our countrymen in Israel as the attacks come.
Well, our effort began as far back as Saturday, 2 days ago, and we set up the Task Force Israel 24/7 help desk to account for OFWs in the affected areas. So currently we are in the process of assisting 25 OFWs and their families. And when I say assisting, I mean to say finding them or keep putting them, placing them in safer ground. And even if they have they're already in safer ground, monitoring their situation. We know of one who got injured in the process of rescue. He got shot in the arm, grazed by a bullet, but he is not in a life-threatening situation. He is in hospital. And with respect to a survey, we put out a Google survey of those in the affected areas most especially, and 281 in the area had said that they are safe. When I say affected area, I mean to say the southern part that is near the Gaza Strip border. And 4 have sought for assistance of the survey respondents, the Google survey respondents. So we are currently assisting them on the ground as we speak.
A while ago, you said that the 10 missing Filipinos, that's now down to 5. Any theory as to where these 5 could be?
Well, the search continues day to day since Saturday. We've cut down those numbers. It used to be around 15 or 16 in the beginning, and now it's down to 5. The effort continues. It's possible that they are in safe rooms or in houses where they had far or not where they were initially registered. In other words, they had transferred or decided to move to places where their fellow Filipinos might be, or where they feel they would be safer. So, so we are not necessarily thinking that they are in harm's way, but rather it's just a matter or an effort to find them, locate them. Of course, communications also poses a challenge. Many had either shut down their cell phones or find it difficult to contact family back home. So we're hoping that we will eventually locate them.
And when you say, when we talk about these 5 who have yet to be accounted for, are we looking at them as a group, or are these 5 individuals in different areas?
At least 2 of them are came from the same kibbutz or farm, and the 3 are in separate areas. Again, we're coordinating with the Israeli Defense Forces and the Filipino community in terms of finding them.
There was an interview with one of the Filipinos there in Israel about how there are undocumented Filipinos out there. What kind of help can be given to the undocumented if, let's say, they're scared? Because once they ask for help, then their status would be known. I mean, you've seen this happen over and over and again, Undersecretary.
Yes, we met with yesterday Ambassador Lilo, Administrator Arnel Ignacio of the OWA, and myself, along with USEC Kaunan and Aliones and Olalia from the BMW met with the Filipino community via video conference facility, and there we had coordinated and talked to them about being part of our network of assistance on the ground, providing information on the ground on the well-being of our OFW. So in short, we have a network of Filipino community leaders who are known to most Filipino community members in Israel, in the southern part, and so we're confident that they can be found, whether they are documented or undocumented. Safer ground essentially means finding the right Filipino homes and communities, and indeed when we find some of those that who were unaccounted for last Saturday, we find out about how they are because they send pictures, group pictures of Filipinos with whom they are now associated or have stayed with. So we are, of course, only too glad to see that the Filipino community also helps those who are unaccounted for, so we eventually locate them.
There have been reports about, you know, how chaotic the situation has spiraled down to. Some reports have it that the Hamas has been on a killing spree. Based on your assessment on the ground and what the community has been telling you, how would you describe the current situation in Israel, Undersecretary?
Well, the way it has been described to us, the Israeli Defense Forces are now operating on the ground. The Hamas attacks happened a couple of days ago. And so we're hoping that somehow the situation has eased in that sense, that there are no grave threats of attack. But having said that, of course, there is still that alert in the sense that people are not advised to step out of their respective places or homes. Most Filipinos are caregivers, meaning they stay with their respective employers in their respective employer households. So we know that they are not necessarily they're not wandering in the streets or find themselves homeless or don't have a roof to stay in. So we are closely monitoring the situation on the ground and coordination again with the Filipino community leaders and the IDF, the Israeli Defense Forces, who have been very helpful in terms of locating our fellow Filipinos and in certain cases even rescuing them.
Yeah, Undersecretary, in that interview as well with a Filipino who is in Israel, he was also sort of concerned as well as to where they can go. There are some shelters out there, but there none seems to be dedicated entirely just for Filipinos. Is this something that you're working towards as well, that there be a shelter specifically for Filipinos, Undersecretary?
Yes, so the shelter specifically for Filipinos is currently being coordinated with our Filipino community members, as mentioned. There are identified Filipino community leaders in the area, in the affected area, and we network them and to provide information as to how a particular OFW who needs shelter or help can go. So this is the effort that is currently being undertaken. The Philippine Embassy in Tel Aviv is in the northern central part of Israel and rather far from the southern part, which is the most affected area. The place has been, cordoned off or off limits, except for the Israeli Defense Forces and those who are there. So we are currently in the effort of coordination and of course, identifying places or persons that the Filipino community could reach out to.
And so again, the latest, no Filipino casualty. As of yet, no reports of abduction, aside from the one that you mentioned that was injured, grazed by a bullet. That's all that we have right now, Undersecretary?
Yes, that's the info that we have right now. But having said that, we are also mindful of the possibility that any one of those to whom we have accounted for may need help even along psychosocial lines, because some of them, when we talk to them, still express some fear or worry. Some of them have just stayed in Israel for 1 or 2 years, so are relatively new to the environment. So we are definitely hand-holding them through this process, even as they are accounted for. And yes, if those any one of them would need medical or physical medical help, then we also stand ready to help them.
Again, your appeal, Undersecretary, to those who are afraid to seek help for fear of their status being made known. At this point, their status is not important. It's their safety that is, Undersecretary.
Yes, please. I think we made it clear also in the video conference we had yesterday with the Filipino community and Filipino community leaders that we do have a hotline, and we want to make it known to everybody that there is a hotline or a communication line that they could all run to, and it is 1-348. That's the basic hotline from Israel. It's +632-1-348. We do have WhatsApp and Viber lines because 1-348 obviously is not a WhatsApp or Viber line. So we also stand ready to help those with the Viber and WhatsApp line. So I just request perhaps Ms. Carmina to have them posted. We already had them have them at the DMW website.
Yeah, and we're showing it as we speak, Undersecretary. We're showing our viewers as we speak, so that maybe their families here as well, who have any queries or concerns, can they use this line as well, Undersecretary?
Yes. Of course, we have Facebook pages as well, and there is also contact information of our labor attaché on the ground, and OWA Administrator Arnell's team on the ground. So please contact any one of these contact lines of communication, and we stand ready to help.
Undersecretary Hans Leo Kakdak there of the Department of Migrant Workers, thanks again for talking to us this noon. Really appreciate it.